Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, we are starting a video like I've never done before. We're gonna do a little bit of dupe hunting here. Now, if you're new here, hi, my name is Morgan. I'm a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about about all of the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. And I primarily am a luxury high-end beauty review channel. However, I do love to dip my toes into more affordable makeup because I do love to compare in my videos. I'm not big on dupes. I'm not good at finding dupes. I'm not one of those people that recognizes dupes because I don't know, I'm so picky and packaging is so important to me. And I feel like I can really tell the differences in formulation. I'm not good at finding dupes, but that's what we're gonna do today because I feel like a lot of e.l.f. products remind me of a lot of my favorite high-end and luxury products. So I am going to be doing dupe hunting and trying to see how e.l.f. products compare to my favorite luxury and high-end products. Now, this video is not sponsored. However, Magic Links, which is one of the affiliate companies that I go through, they did offer to send me an e.l.f. gift card, and I was like, what cool video could I make? So that's that. We are on the e.l.f. website right now. So we're gonna go by category, and I do have some e.l.f. products already that I know I want to compare that are in my collection because I've never actually compared them side by side to a luxury or high-end product, but I wanna see if there's any new stuff. So we're gonna go in order. The first one that we have are primers. Now, obviously, the putty primers, you are going to want to compare those to the Tatcha Silk Canvas. Everybody's done that. And I actually want to compare the Jelly Pop Dew Face Primer to one of my other grippy primers. I have that already, so I'm not gonna add it to my basket. So I think we already have the face primer on lock from what I can see. They have a lot of primers though, lots of primers. I am curious though about this acne fighting one because your girl got acne, so I'm gonna add that to my cart, but we're not gonna compare that to anything. Also, I went to try this one. I'm gonna be shopping at the same time that we do this. Okay, let's go to foundation. Now, e.l.f. isn't really known for their foundations. The one that I immediately thought of course, was the Camo CC Cream to the IT Cosmetics. I've already done a whole video comparing those two. So we're gonna do a BB cream, I think. This one actually reminds me a lot of the Clinique. I don't even own the Clinique though. And I would definitely want to compare the products to my favorite. So I love the CC cream, so I think I'm just gonna go ahead and compare these two again in that video. We'll just do another comparison, what does it hurt, because the IT Cosmetics really is my favorite, and this one is pretty much a direct dupe, so I'm gonna reuse those because I have to. Let's move to concealer. So everybody compares the Tarte Shape Tape to the e.l.f. Camo Concealer, so I'm actually gonna compare the Hydrating Camo Concealer to the Tarte Hydrating Shape Tape. So I already have this concealer, but it is not in the right shade. Ooh, light sand, perfect. This is the color that I need. So I'm buying a new color, and that's perfect. Concealer is a check. Let's go to powder. I'm doing this in my head by the order that I apply things in, and I want to try, let's see. I want to compare to my Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finishing Powder. So I don't know if I should do the Prime and Stay Finishing Powder or the Beautifully Bare Sheer Tint. I feel like this one, lightweight tinted powder, blurs the face. Like, this feels like it claims the same that the Charlotte Tilbury does, but so does this one. We'll do this one. Let's be interesting. Let's compare the $3 one to the Charlotte Tilbury one. I'm gonna go ahead and should I do sheer or light medium? Let's do sheer. So powder is done. I do have a loose powder. I'll see if I want to compare that to anything. I'm going to think it over. But this is the main powder that I wanted to compare. Okay, let's move on to bronzer. And I know exactly what I want to do. This is part of the reason why I wanted to do this video. e.l.f. just came out with a putty bronzer, you guys. So we're going to compare this to one of my creams. I'm going to see what the consistency is like and what I have in my collection. But I think, Feeling Shady looks very, very gray. Let me do tan lines. What do the swatches look like? Maybe Honey Drip. I'm going to add that and we'll see what the total ends up being. Let's see, is there anything else? That was the main one that I wanted to do. Side note, I love it. Their cream palette. I already have this bronzer, so I think that's what we will compare to. Okay, let's move on to blush. Now, I already own the putty blush and I already own the monochromatic. I own a lot of the blushes actually now that I'm looking at it. So I think we'll be good on this category. The only thing that I do want to compare though, I want to get another color of the monochrome multi-stick because I feel like there's a lot of products out right now that are comparable to this. And I have one shade, but I want to get another one because I feel like I don't have a color that matches it. So I want something, not glimmering guava. I feel like they're very, very shiny. I want something that's more of a true flat color. Okay, we'll do glimmering guava. That's fine. That looks like I have something close to it, if I can remember at the top of my head. But I think we're good on blush from e.l.f. Let's look at their highlighters. Now, I wasn't sure with highlighters. They have a lot of different formulations, and I can't really think right away of what I'm reminded of. Like, the jelly highlighter I would want to compare to my Too Faced one that I have, but I decluttered that, so clearly it wasn't that much of a favorite of mine. But I'm thinking that this reminds me, the metallic flare highlighter, a lot of my pressed gelée highlighters that I have, like Natasha Denona. So I think we'll compare that. Let me see, what colors do I want? We'll do white gold. I'm a fair girl, so. But I also am... Maybe rose gold looks really pretty. I want the colors to be somewhat similar, so that's why I'm purchasing a couple colors of one product because I want them to kind of match. And we'll do setting spray and powders. Let's see. I don't think there's anything in the setting spray that we need. Okay, so I think we're good. With the face, let's move on to eyes. Now, eyes is going to be hard. For eyeshadows, I wasn't sure really. Like, this clay eyeshadow, it's sold out, so no. I do have a couple liquid glitter eyeshadows, so I might feature that. We will see, but I already have them in my collection. I'm not sure. This reminds me of my Naked 3 palette, and I love my Naked 3 palette, but I don't know if it's, like, relevant enough, you know? I'm not looking for dupe for dupes color-wise for the eyeshadows. Like, these remind me a lot of the Natasha Denona, so I'm gonna see if there's a color maybe that reminds me of a Natasha Denona that I have. I don't even remember what colors I have. That's, I'm embarrassing. I have this one. Well, you know, I have most of these. So I want to at least get a palette that I haven't tried before, maybe. Let's take a look. Okay, I'm actually going to get the new Classics eyeshadow palette because I feel like I have some, like, my ABH palettes I could compare to this. Like the Sultry, Soft Glam. So we're going to do that. Let's move on to eyebrows next. I think I already have what I want, the Ultra Precise Brow Pen. So I'm going to compare that to probably the ABH or the Benefit. And the Wow Brow Gel, I'm going to compare to what a couple of my favorites have been. Do they have a clear one? I prefer that. Looks like they don't. So I'm going to pick up the neutral brown shade. So there's a couple products that I use that I love from high-end makeup. So I'm going to do that. I have the Lash It Loud. I think I'm just going to compare that to another mascara. I'm not a big mess. Oh, we'll do the Big Mood. I feel like I have a mascara in mind that would work well for. Eyeliner. My all-time favorite gel liner is the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. Do they have, they only have it in coffee. They don't have it in black. I can do the pen if I need to. Yeah, I have a lot of pens that I love, so we'll just do that. We'll do eye primer next, and I want to try the glitter primer because I'm big on glitter primers, and I think that will be it for eyes. Now let's move on to lips. Do they have lip liner? I have these. They don't really have any good lip liner products. I'm surprised. Okay, let's move on to lipsticks though. I'm gonna go with their Seriously Satin lipsticks and I'm gonna see what colors I have could match up. So I'm gonna order a couple colors. We're gonna get Taffy. They're only $3. God, I love e.l.f. Let's do Nectar. These look like colors I would have a lot of. Taffy. Persimmon looks really fun. And throw that in there. Why not? any other formulas? And I'm going to play with these products a little bit first before I decide to do the correct comparisons, just because I want to make sure they're at least comparable. These sheer slick lipsticks are really awesome. I'm going to pick up a couple of these because these are very comparable to a lot of the formulas that are popular now. They have very bright shades in these. Like, what color should I get? I guess I'll just get the one. I don't even know where to start with these, but the formula is very popular right now, even in the high-end industry. I think we've covered it. I'm trying to see, do they not have any glosses? Gloss, okay. Tinted lip oils. Those are very popular right now. I'm gonna try one tinted lip oil. The Nude Kiss, we're basic here. I'm on a lip plumping gloss. Champagne Glam. Pink Sugar. Oh, we're frozen, I suppose. Anyways, I'm gonna stop the shopping spree right here. In like 5 seconds, the package will have arrived. So thanks for shopping with me. Look what came in the mail today. My e.l.f. order. I have been waiting a week for this guy. The anticipation, it has been killing me. And I think waiting, and this video honestly requires way more prep than my normal videos. All of that, I've not been this excited to film a video in a long time. I have laid everything out on my desk and I have paired products together. I really just want to see how they compare because it's no secret. Like, as much as I love my high-end and luxury makeup, you can get great makeup at a much more affordable price. So I'm really intrigued, really excited to see how different they are, because while I know how formulations differ from wearing them this time and then the next time, I've never really gone side by side, head to head, to really see how full face of luxury makeup and high-end makeup would compare to e.l.f. And I'm really excited. Now, from when I was going through my collection, not all of these items are going to be complete color dupes. I tried to get as close as I could, but I'm really more interested in the formulation as opposed to the actual color. So one side might look a little bit different based on color, but I'm really paying attention to the formulations. We're gonna start off with primer. So ultimately what I decided, we're gonna do the e.l.f. Jelly Pop Dew Primer on one side. This is $10. And then we are going to compare it to the Urban Decay All Nighter Ultra Glow Face Primer, which is $36. So almost four times the price. These have reminded me of each other ever since I started using both of them. They both are this gel consistency. They both are a little bit sticky. They leave the face feeling a little bit tacky. I really like the Urban Decay and I really like the e.l.f. So we'll see side by side how they do. So we're going to start off with my e.l.f. This one smells like watermelons. I love it. The Urban Decay does not smell like watermelon. Honestly, that e.l.f. primer is a little bit more expensive than the rest of their line. Okay, so instantly what I can tell you is the e.l.f. primer is a little bit more sticky. The Urban Decay is definitely gliding on a lot more easily. It's not tugging at the skin. I'm gonna give them both a couple seconds to set and we'll kind of feel the differences between the tackiness. So yeah, the e.l.f. definitely feels more sticky and a little bit less hydrating. The Urban Decay definitely feels smoother. Now, I know everybody compares the Tatcha primer to the e.l.f. putty primer. Since everybody has already done that, I wanted to do something different. That's why I chose those two over the putty primers. We're gonna move on to foundation. This is the one category where I think I failed, because the easy one to do is the e.l.f. CC compared to the It Cosmetics CC, but I already have a whole video on that, so I wanted to do something different. I wanted to do something with the e.l.f. Flawless Satin Foundation. So what I noticed the characteristics of this is that it's satin, it's a lighter medium coverage, kind of a middle of the road foundation. It is only $6. So a foundation that I love that's in my collection that I thought had similar characteristics was the Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation. This is $40. That's a big price difference. $6 versus $40. Now when I get these on my face, they could be completely different. It's been a while since I've used this one, but I feel like they have similar characteristics. And like I said, I just wanted to see how one applied. Actually, I think I'm gonna start doing the high-end side first, since I'm more familiar with most of these formulas. I will admit though, it's been a hot minute since I've used this Dior foundation. I don't know how similar these are gonna be This was definitely my one fail. Probably put way too much on, didn't I? Now that I have this Dior foundation on, while it is beautiful, which is why I put it in this video, I feel like it's going to be a lot different than the e.l.f. So these are not dupes, but we're just going to compare them. e.l.f. is on this side. The Dior is a lot more liquidy. This one is a little bit thicker. I'm applying a lot because I applied a lot of the Dior. I'm going to get the clean side of my sponge, push it in. You can see that the color is different. It's fine. It is what it is. Honestly, the e.l.f. is providing a little bit more coverage than the Dior did. What is a good foundation you think to compare the e.l.f. to? I really like this foundation. I feel like it's underrated. They're $6. It's really nice. Okay, so here is the e.l.f. side versus the Dior side. The Dior side is much more glowy, a little bit more natural. We'll see how the wear differs. Again, this comparison is a little bit of a fail, but that's okay. Just in the order that I do things, we are going to go to eyebrows next. I am going to compare the e.l.f. Ultra Precise Brow Pencil. There's lots of options for high end, but I'm gonna do a popular one, the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. So the e.l.f. is $5 and the Benefit is $24. That's a big difference just because we go through eyebrow products really quickly. Anyways, even the Benefit goes fast. So you could really be saving a lot of money in the eyebrow department. And I'm very familiar with both products, but I just wanted to see how they would compare side by side. I mean, the Benefit is just a solid product all around. You know, you can't beat it. It's been a favorite for years. Okay, we're gonna put on the e.l.f. now. I feel like the Benefit applies more pigmentation and more of a precise line, whereas the e.l.f. you do have to push down a little bit harder and it's not quite as precise. Being completely honest, I do just like the Benefit better. I like the way that it's a lot more precise. The e.l.f. is really great though for $5. I would repurchase this when I finish it, but if I'm looking for really hair-like strokes, the Benefit is the way to go. Okay, I did also want to do some gel products for the eyebrows. They're both tinted. So the high-end option that I'm going for is a newer option, but I've been loving it. This is the Kosas Airbrow. And then we are going to compare that to the e.l.f. Wow Brow in neutral brown. Let's see. Let's compare the spoolies here. One of the things that I love most about the Kosas is the spoolie. They are very similar. You'll see that the e.l.f. has more of a spiral to it. I don't know. We'll see. So the e.l.f. Wow Brow is $4. The Kosas, $22. So what I love most about the Kosas is how thick makes my brows look. I really need to trim my eyebrows. I also really like how the Kosas doesn't deposit too much color. I feel like the Kosas was getting into the brows more, whereas the spoolie on the e.l.f. isn't grabbing the brows more. So this seems to take control of the eyebrow hairs a little bit better. I will be honest, we'll have to see how it wears, but I don't think it's enough to justify the price difference. Very interesting, and they both were really good. They didn't deposit too much color, and my eyebrows look different. It's not because of the products, it's because of the eyebrows. Eyebrows are different. Okay, this was a comparison that I was really excited for. So I chose to use the Tarte Ultra Creamy Shape Tape. I've been using it a lot recently in preparation for this video to get a real feel for the formula. And I want to compare that to the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. So a popular comparison has been the e.l.f. Camo Concealer and the Tarte Shape Tape. They both came out with creamy versions, so we are going to test both. Now, I have experience with the Hydrating Camo Concealer, but the shade that I have is really dark. So I did repurchase a new shade, but I think this shade is still too dark. I used to have a light version to mix in with the e.l.f., but the packaging broke, so I had to throw it away. Anyways, this guy is $6 from e.l.f., and the price of the Tarte is $29. This is probably the closest price range that we've seen so far. I'm gonna just put some right here and some right here. I think that's the popular TikTok way of doing things, right? Just want to make sure we're applying an even amount of the product. Okay, nice coverage. Let's go into the e.l.f. now. I have mine in the shade Light Sand. It has a little bit more peachiness to it compared to my Tarte, which is in Light Neutral. Okay, a little bit goes a lot farther with the e.l.f. I might have put just a little bit more on than the Tarte, but it's thicker, so it was harder to really control how much came out. I think just for a fair comparison, I do want to put a little bit more of the Tarte on. They both look pretty much the same. I really cannot tell the difference. So that's good. To make everything look a bit more even though, because my face is so much brighter on this side, I'm gonna put just a little bit more of the e.l.f. concealer right here, just to brighten up the center of my face. That looks better that way. Okay, so these, very, very close to each other. We'll have to see how they wear. Ooh, this one I was really curious about. So I picked up the Prime and Stay Finishing Powder. And when I heard the word finishing powder, I saw it in a circular compact. I immediately thought of my all-time favorite Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finishing Powder. So I picked up the shade Fair Light in the e.l.f. I fear that this is lighter than my Charlotte Tilbury Lipsy. Price difference on this is insane. The e.l.f. is $3. The Charlotte Tilbury, $45. I know. So I'm gonna use the lightest shade of the Charlotte Tilbury. Let's see how it compares to Fair Light in the e.l.f. The e.l.f. is much brighter, which in this case works since my foundation is deeper. We'll do my beloved Charlotte Tilbury first. I actually don't really like this powder for setting the under eyes, but we're gonna use it today for that. Just in the center parts of my face, the areas that crease a lot more, beautiful as always. Wiped off my brush, moment of truth. Let's go into the e.l.f. This feels a little bit more powdery. Let's get a closer look. The e.l.f. side looks a little bit more dry, but keep in mind that could be due to the actual products underneath since they are different. I mean, generally speaking, the high-end side looks better for me, but not bad. The Charlotte Tilbury feels just a little bit more hydrating, a little bit more creamy compared to the e.l.f., but $3 versus $45, you can't beat that. Okay, let's move on. I have a new product. So e.l.f. recently came out with their putty bronzer. So I got mine in the shade Hand Lines. So I was looking through my cream bronzers and the closest shade I could find was the Huda Beauty Tantour in the shade Fair, which is awesome because this is probably my favorite cream bronzer of all time. So it worked out. So here is Fair in the Huda versus Tan Lines. You can see Tan Lines has a little bit more warmth, but they seem to be pretty similar. So the e.l.f. is going to cost you $6. The Tantour is going to cost $30. So let me see the difference in texture. So the e.l.f. is the top swatch. They feel very, very similar. You can see the difference. I would say that the Huda feels a little bit creamier and the e.l.f. feels a touch greasier. Not in a bad way, but feel like it has a little bit more oil to it and it has less pigmentation. So let's apply the Tantour first. I like to use it by putting the butt end of my sponge in the product. You can see we have lots of color here. Ugh, I love this so much. It's my favorite. And don't forget to get down here. I mean, this product is beautiful. Nothing weird over the powder. I purposefully put powder down first to see if the e.l.f. product would react. That's beautiful. Let me wipe my sponge off so we don't get transfer. Okay, let's go in to the e.l.f. now. Okay, so instantly, a lot less pigmentation, which is not a bad thing at all. Oh, but it looks very pretty. Let's take a little bit more building up, that's for sure. So here is the e.l.f. side. Here's the Huda side. So the Huda provides a little bit more coverage, and I think the e.l.f. side has a little bit more of a shine, whereas the Huda, it's not matte, but it's more matte than the e.l.f., but the colors are pretty spot on the face. Hmm. Wow. That's awesome. Okay, we are gonna move on to blush next. And I chose cream blush. Everybody's really into the cream products. I really wanted to see how the e.l.f. Monochromatic Multi Stick compared to the Nude Sticks Nudies Bloom All Over Face Color. So these both have kind of the same idea in that you can use them on the lips, on the cheeks, wherever you want. I tried to get the closest colors possible. They're gonna look a little bit different on the face. They're just not the same. But the e.l.f. stick is $4. Nude Sticks, $34. That's a $30 difference. So I have the shade Glimmering Guava in the e.l.f. And what's very different about this that I just couldn't replicate is there are some gold reflex in here. I chose the dewy version of the Nude Sticks, but the color is different. There's not that gold sheen in here. This is a shade Bohemian Rose. I mean, they're not very close. I did the best that I could. Instantly, I would say the Nude Sticks feels creamier. It has a different finish. These aren't the same product, but I want to see how wear time is different, all of that. So I'm going to take the top of my sponge of the Nude Sticks. I'm going to put this right on top. I love these. They are amazing. They really are so multi-purpose. I really only use them on the cheeks, but sometimes I'll use them on the lips just for like a quick balm, you know? That's so pretty. I'll put the e.l.f. on top, but it's not going to stay there because I do have some cheek products. Blended beautifully. Looks beautiful. Gives a nice sheen. The Glimmering Guava. Honestly, I have another one of these. Let me see if it's closer in shade. So I have the shade Dazzling Peony. Honestly, okay, this one looks a little bit closer. So we're going to use Dazzling Peony instead. And it has less reflex, which is nice. Okay, good. I feel better about doing these side by side now. Here we go. So the color might be different, but I'm just testing the formulations here. So Nude Sticks is giving off more color and a little bit more of a glow. A different kind of glow because the e.l.f. has like a reflective kind of glow because of the shimmers in there. Whereas the Nude Sticks gives you more of a skin-like glow because of the texture. It's a little bit thicker. Okay. So one thing that I'm noticing is the e.l.f. is not doing well on top of the powder, whereas the Nude Sticks, it was really not that big of a deal. The e.l.f. is also looking a bit more greasy on the skin. Oh, it like completely took off the foundation. There's a big difference there. You see this compared to this? That's not very pretty. Going to try and aid it by putting on just a little bit more of the e.l.f. foundation, but I would say definitely go for the Nude Sticks over the e.l.f. as far as cream blush, if you're going to use it as a cream blush. So a lot of the foundation came off in this area, so I'm just putting a little bit more on. Hopefully it doesn't look too wonky. So I think of everything, this is the one product where I'm like, ooh, the high end is much better. I'm going to try and put just a touch more of this just to bring the color back to my face. But I really am trying not to disrupt anything. Next up, we have highlight. I'm excited for these two. But I have this e.l.f. highlight, which looks like it's a baked gelée formula in the shade Rose Gold. And so I was thinking, what are my favorite high-end like gelée kind of formulas? And I put out the Natasha Denona I Need a Nude Glow, which looks like this. So the e.l.f. is going to be $6, Natasha Denona $42. That's a big difference. Now these are not shade dupes. You can see the tones are different. So the e.l.f. one, you can see, has that rosy tone, whereas the Natasha has more of a champagne tone. These are the closest I could get in terms of shade to each other, but we'll see how it sits on the skin. Using my blinged brush, F17, we're gonna start off with the Natasha Denona. Got a good 5 swipes in there. This is one of my favorite highlights. Really beautiful. Doesn't emphasize the texture of the skin too much. Wiping off my brush, let's go into the e.l.f. now. So the color is going to be a bit different. It's okay. Honestly, I think I'm gonna mix it because I bought 2 colors of these because I think it is a bit deeper. So I'm gonna mix in a bit of white gold just to brighten everything up. Ooh, okay, so here is the e.l.f. side. We have the Natasha side. The e.l.f. looks a little bit more metallic, whereas the Natasha looks a little bit more one with the skin. So the reflect is a bit different, but they look pretty close. I would say, wow, I am impressed. Okay, it is time to get into eyeshadows. This is the one that I struggled with the most besides the foundation as far as finding something close. But I ultimately decided to get the e.l.f., the new Classics palette, which looks like this. I felt like it had a lot of universal colors, which would be in a lot of my high-end palettes. So this is $14 and it looks really great and wearable. I've been wanting this one anyway, so I was excited to have a reason to purchase it. And one of my favorite palettes that I felt like had a lot of similar shades was the Scott Barnes Snatchel palette. I was going back and forth between the Scott Barnes and a couple of my ABH palettes, but I wanted a palette that had a lot of options. So it's not dupe for dupe color story wise, but there are a lot of similar shades. So especially the mattes here, I feel like are repetitive. And there are some shimmers that are very comparable as well. The Scott Barnes has shimmers that pull more warm compared to the e.l.f. Anything, honestly, I might like the e.l.f. color story better. But I'm trying to get as close of a look as possible without looking like a Maniac. So I thought that these two would be good. Like I said, the e.l.f. is $14. Scott Barnes over here, $84. So that's almost 8 times the price. Didn't get an eye primer. So to keep it fair, to really see how the eyeshadows wear, I'm just going to use the Makeup by Mario base on both eyes. I'm going to go color by color on each eye just to make sure we can get them as close as possible to each other. Side note, if you are interested in getting this, I don't really recommend it. Okay, I'm going to use Vintage from Scott Barnes on this eye. This is our transition color. The look's probably going to be really simple. This is the perfect time to pull out my Odin's Eye brush cleaner. Okay. And then I thought Truffle right here looked really close to that shade. Elf kind of has more pigment. Would you look at that? We're going to deepen up with Foxy right here. Pop it right in the outer corner. Blend it. And then Darling looks a bit warm for that shade. So I'm going to go like 2 in Darling and then like I did 3 in Darling and then 2 in Earth to kind of neutralize. Oh yeah, that's like a nice match. And I'm editing it out, but I am going in with my brush cleaner before I touch each eye. Because I'm just going back and forth to really try and get them as even as possible. I'm going to take some of Woody. This is going right along my lower lash line. I think we're going to go pretty smoky down here. You'll notice this shade was extremely pigmented. I think I'm going to try and blend it out a little bit. I'm going to go in with Earth, just Earth this time. The shade is also extremely pigmented. I will say I do feel like the Scott Barnes is blending out a touch more seamlessly, but I mean, if you have a little bit of skill in eyeshadow, I think you'll be okay. I'm gonna go in with Temptation down here. Really focus this in the outer corner, outer V area. Like that, beautiful. And in the e.l.f., I'm gonna go into Muse and like dot once in Noir because it is a touch darker in the Scott Barnes palette. But with that little bit of the dot in the black, you see how that made everything match? Honestly, I feel like these palettes, as far as the mattes go, have the same level of pigmentation, which is awesome. I'm gonna go in with a clean brush and blend out these edges. I'm looking into the shimmers now to see what we have that is close. The textures and finishes do seem to be different just because Scott Barnes has a little bit more reflect in it. It looks prettier, whereas the e.l.f. is a little bit more of like a plain kind of shimmer. So to amp it up, we are going to use some glitter glue. Now, e.l.f. does have a glitter glue, which I did not know. Their glitter primer is only $3, and then I have the Too Faced Shadow Insurance Glitter Glue that is $24. $3 versus $24. So the shades that I think I'm going to compare are Rose Gold from the e.l.f. palette. I'm comparing that to Starlet in the Scott Barnes palette because they're similar finishes, but they aren't similar colors. You can see the difference there, but I didn't think it would be fair to use one of the prettier Scott Barnes glittery colors. And I have to say the e.l.f. seems a little bit more pigmented than the Scott Barnes. Now I will say where the Scott Barnes palette is superior is the fact that it does have those more multi-dimensional shades that quite frankly the e.l.f. just does not have, but is it enough to justify like $70? Probably not. Okay, so the e.l.f. glitter glue is a lot more liquidy. It's a little bit more difficult to control. I'm gonna go into Rose Gold right here. And I don't know that it's really grabbing on to this shadow that well. A gray glitter primer from the drugstore is NYX. That one you really can't tell too much of a difference between the Too Faced. Really pretty. Okay, I'm gonna use the Too Faced now. Yeah, the Too Faced is not as liquidy, so it's a little bit easier to manipulate because I feel like with glitter glue, you want to put it in a certain spot because you don't want shadow to stick where you don't want it to stick. So the Too Faced is definitely easier to work out. Obviously, the shades are different, but I do prefer the e.l.f. shimmer to the Scott Barnes. However, the glittery shades down here are prettier than what you're gonna get in the e.l.f. I'm gonna mix in a little bit of Hollywood and Siren on this eye just to try and get a closer match to both eyes. So it's going to have a little bit more dimension now, but I just want to get them to be a closer match. So Siren, actually, I'm blending into it. And then you can instantly see that this eye is more multi-dimensional. And I know it looks crazy. I'm going to mix them. All right, you guys. So honestly, I mean, here's the truth. If you're a regular on my channel, I call myself an eyeshadow snob. For me, since I love eyeshadow so much, I am okay with paying more for a better formulation. The Scott Barnes, it's blending easier. I think the shimmers are prettier, except for that starlit shade that I put on my lid. The e.l.f. shimmers are really, really nice. But the e.l.f. is a great, great palette to have, especially this one with this color story. I do notice a difference in quality, but is it enough to justify $70? For most people, probably not, unless you're a true makeup enthusiast like myself and you really love high-end luxury makeup. I don't think for the average person it is enough to justify the price difference between the two. I can tell a difference. The Scott Barnes is better, but it's not miles better. So take with that what you will. The looks look pretty close, not exact, but pretty close. Let's move on to eyeliner. So I have my Charlotte Tilbury, the Feline Flick. It's a really great felt tip liner. This is $30, and I'm gonna try the e.l.f. H2O Proof Eyeliner Pen in the shade Jet Black. This one is $6. So we have $6 versus $36. Let me compare the tips for you. Pretty close. You can see the Charlotte Tilbury is just a bit longer. Let me throw on my Charlotte Tilbury really quickly. Beautiful. Okay, let's try the e.l.f. Now, I have had experience with e.l.f. eyeliners in the past. I haven't been the biggest fan of them, but I've never tried this. I'm like, I don't know which way to hold the mirror. Here we go. Eyeliner is something that I don't mess with. There are a lot of really bad eyeliners on the market that I've tried, and I will pay whatever it takes to have a good liner because you look terrible if you're wearing a bad liner. Charlotte Tilbury has a little bit more flexibility in the felt tip, which doesn't really matter. But as far as the product, the Charlotte Tilbury is much more black to the e.l.f. and there's more product that comes out with the Charlotte Tilbury, making it more easy to use. However, this eyeliner from e.l.f., as long as it holds up, is a nice eyeliner for $6. This is one of the better drugstore eyeliners that I've tried. It's not quite black enough for me. The Charlotte Tilbury just, it's better. And since I think an eyeliner is so important, I'm gonna spend the $30. But if an eyeliner is good, it doesn't matter the price to me. I'll spend $6, I'll spend $30. There's a Maybelline eyeliner that I think is a bit better than this one, but the e.l.f. is really good in a pinch, so I really like this. I did get mascaras. I've said this before, I'm not the best to judge mascaras, but I picked these up kind of last second. So I chose the e.l.f. Big Mood Mascara. I wasn't sure exactly which one I was gonna compare this to at the time that I purchased it, but it looked big, it looked like a big fat brush, and I felt like I had some mascaras that were similar. I don't wanna open up new mascaras because I do have mascaras that are definitely comparable to this. So the closest wand I could find was the Pat McGrath Labs Dark Star Mascara, along with this being one of my favorite mascaras. So we're just going to compare these two. I normally don't like mascaras on first use. This is not the first use, so it's going to be hard to compare these two, but let me show you the wand differences. So they both have an hourglass wand, but you will see the e.l.f. definitely has a fatter wand. Like I said, this was the closest I could do. I'm gonna go off camera and do this because otherwise we're gonna be sitting here for an hour. Okay, this e.l.f. mascara, it's not my favorite. It's a little bit too wet. It's not separating my lashes. I'm not going to knock this out yet just because I feel like if it dried a little bit, I would like it more. But the wand is also a bit too big for my preference, so this is just not the mascara for me. However, you might like it. Again, I don't like to review mascaras because I don't have good lashes. I'm gonna put on false lashes. They're gonna be the same lashes. I know e.l.f. does have lashes, but I don't like them in general. So I'm gonna pop on my falsies and I will be back. Lashes are on. Eyes are looking more similar. So we're gonna move on to lips. And e.l.f. didn't really have the biggest selection of lip liners. They had one kit that contained 4 lip liners and a lip gloss for only $10. So I have that kit, so I picked one of the lip liners, which is $3. I averaged it out. Technically $2 probably would have been the price, but anyways, it was a set. We're gonna say this lip liner was $3. I guess I'm using the e.l.f. side first for this. I've used both a lot, so. This is a really good lip liner, by the way. I like how it's a little bit more stiff. Like, it's still creamy, but you have some control. And I'm going to compare that to my favorite Pat McGrath Labs lip liner and contour. This is $28. Do I pay that much for a lip liner? Oh my goodness. This glides on a lot easier. And I would say, if I didn't know already how the Pat McGrath wore, I would tell you I actually liked the e.l.f. better. But here's the thing with Pat McGrath. This is a rare breed. This is a formula that is so creamy to apply, but it doesn't budge. I've used both of these. The Pat lasts longer. It's more creamy. But the e.l.f. lip liners, don't sleep on them. I wish they would come out with more and you could buy them in more than just a set. Because e.l.f. in general has a really nice lip liner formula. We're gonna do lipstick now. These are not the same color. I swatched a billion lip colors. So I'm gonna compare the e.l.f. satin lipstick, which is $3, to my favorite lipstick formula, the Natasha Denona I Need a Nude lipstick line. This is $25. $3, $25, you could buy like 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. 8 lipsticks for the price of one Natasha Denona, but the Natasha Denona formula can't be beat. This is the shade Andrea. It's like a nude color, and I'm comparing it to the shade Cream from e.l.f., which is a little bit more pinky, but close enough. So the Natasha formula, it's creamier. It's my all-time favorite lipstick formula. I'm more partial to Natasha Denona, but $3 for the e.l.f., it's really, really good. This is a nice formula. And our last comparison is lip gloss. The colors aren't that close, but I do have the e.l.f. lip lacquer for $3. Comparing it to my Fenty gloss, that is $19. I have the cream lip gloss in Fenty Glow, which is a little bit more of a pink. Just putting that right on top. One of the best formulations. The problem with this video that's making it hard is I'm picking my absolute favorite formulas and the e.l.f. just isn't matching up. So this lip lacquer is in the shade Wild Rose. It's a different color all around. It's not as creamy. It's not as shiny, but it's a solid lip gloss formula. It's fine, but you can see that difference in shine there. And the Fenty definitely feels more hydrating. All right, you guys, that was everything. Take one last look at the difference between my e.l.f. side and my high-end side. I can tell you now just by looking, the high-end side, particularly the skin, looks a lot better. I think what really messed this up was the stick because it looks really dry and my under eyes do not look good on this side, and I think it's more so to do with the powder and a little bit with the concealer, but I think it's more the powder. But I mean, you can even see on camera. The high-end side is visibly more blurred, more smooth. I much prefer it, that's for sure. However, when I tell you the price of everything, you're gonna be like, you might wanna go for e.l.f. So the price of e.l.f., everything that I use today, only $89, under $100 for the full face. The price of the high-end luxury side, $542. Not quite, but almost a $500 difference. Is it worth it to you? So I wanna finish off this video, and I will do a little bit of a wear time update after this, but I wanna finish off by telling you what the best products from e.l.f. are that really do compare to my high-end favorites. I think eyebrows, you know, if there's one area in high-end that you should save on, it's going to be eyebrows, the e.l.f. eyebrow pencils, and the gel did a fabulous job. Depending on how it wears, I think the e.l.f. putty bronzer put up a good fight against the Huda Tantor. Again, I do think the Tantor is better, but the actual finish, very, very close, looks really good. The highlights, very, very similar on the face. It hurts me to admit this, but the eyeshadow palettes also very close in quality. I will say e.l.f. quality is not my favorite, especially when you get more into the colorful tones, but as far as just these neutrals, the e.l.f. did a great job. Normally, neutrals are easier to formulate, so that's what I'm assuming. So when it comes to neutral shades, the e.l.f. is really good. It puts up a fight. Again, prefer the high-end formulas if you have the money, but if you don't have the money or you're looking to save, e.l.f. is a good alternative. Eyeliner really impressed me from e.l.f. There are some bad eyeliners from e.l.f., but so far I really like this one. Lip liner puts up a good battle, as does the lipstick. So as far as what you need to stay away from that you just can't replace with high-end, I will be honest, I much prefer the Urban Decay primer. It just feels better on the skin. I don't think the foundation was a fair battle, so I'm just gonna leave it at that. I mean, the high-end side looks better, but they were different products. The concealer, I much prefer the Tarte. The e.l.f. is good and a lot of people love it, but the Tarte just looks smoother and it's wearing better. So that's the main difference. And I mean, the $3 versus the $45 powder, I mean, my skin looks completely different. This is one product that I would say, I know it's a huge difference, but the Charlotte Tilbury is worth the difference from what I'm seeing on my skin. It's so blurring. It's so perfecting. I mean, this was a disaster. Nude sticks all the way. This broke up my foundation. It did not look good. While I don't think you need the Too Faced primer, I really am not a fan of the e.l.f. glitter primer, really. I would suggest NYX if you're looking for something more affordable. You know, I wasn't the biggest fan of the mascara, but I don't want to compare that because it's a brand new one. But I mean, yeah, that's pretty much it. For the most part, I think e.l.f. put up a good battle for sure, and I'm quite impressed. I'm gonna insert my wear test here, and then I will finish with my outro. Oh my gosh, I can't believe what a grease ball I look like right now. Okay, I actually don't look this greasy in person. I'm just sitting in front of a really strong ring light that's bouncing off my skin, but let's take a close look. I have worn the makeup for 9 hours, so this is a really long time, no touch-up. I mean, you can tell me if you think it looks any different. I'm going to say the high-end side, I mean, these are all of my favorite products. It looks better. I'm much happier with the skin, especially along the under eyes here. I'm not sure if it was the concealer, the powder, or if because I had to go over the powder with more foundation because of this cheek mess up, but something here wasn't working. You can see that the Scott Barnes eyeshadow is longer wearing than the e.l.f. The e.l.f. faded just a bit, but yeah, see the foundation picked up over here. The highlight looks super bomb though. That highlight is really comparable. I'm very happy with that. Overall, I mean, throughout the day, the high-end side was looking better, but that's the way it should be. It was 5 times the price. But my takeaway from this video really is, and I mean, I knew this before, but hopefully what you can take away from this is it is okay to buy affordable makeup. You can definitely make it work. This side being $89 and this side being $540. It doesn't look like that big of a difference on the skin. The only person who really can notice it is me, because I'm looking in a mirror, and then you guys, because you are looking in this very HD camera, but from afar, it really is hard to tell, so don't feel bad about missing out on the high-end makeup, but of course, you guys know I'm a proponent of buy what you want, buy what makes you happy. These are the facts of how the products were. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That is the end of my wear test. So that is all I have for today's video. I hope you guys had as much fun as me. I've been thinking about this video a lot. It's different from what I've ever done before. It's a lot of work, but it was a good time. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would love it if you would consider taking the time to do so. And we'll see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.